It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Curtis family. Wynn, Bev, Kathy, Yvonne, and Lindy, ready for action. And the Badger family. Rod, Shauna, Becky, Pat, and Dick. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Welcome. We meet here once a week for a reason. What is it, Gene Lord? Oh, it's things like that, Gene, that keeps you exactly where you are, right in the middle of the audience at this moment. Nah, he's magic. Yeah, Mr. Gene, let's welcome, because he's my buddy. Gene. Here, see. He also moves like that when he's going to get a close-up that he turns the back of his head and bows. And another reason that you're in the aisle, you yo-yo. There he goes. All right, now we get here, meet two nice families. One of them got a chance to win over $10,000. Meet the first family here, the Curtis family. I saw you come down early.
Oh, I hoped you were going to kiss me.
How you doing?
Oh, fine.
You're gorgeous. Who have you got here?
Well, I have my lovely family here.
Yeah.
Three generations. This is my daughter, Beverly.
Hello.
And her daughter, Kathy. And my daughter, Yvonne, and her daughter, Lindy. How about that?
You're beautiful.
Thank you, dear.
Yes, you may applaud. They're beautiful. Where do you live?
Well, we all live in Orange County in
various places.
Yes.
So when I go to Disneyland, I could probably...
Well, yes, you could come
in and
drop
see you
on any of us, you know.
You've always wondered where President Ford's wind buttons went. Here's one of them right here. Wind. The only person I've ever seen wear one, but... We're delighted to have you here. Here's a family going to get you called Badgers. How you doing?
Pretty good.
Let's meet your family, Ron.
Richard, this is my wife, Shauna.
Hello.
My cousin, Becky. My cousin, Pat. And Pat's husband, Dick.
How are you? What do you do?
I'm a medical student at the University of California in San Diego.
She's a doctor.
Yeah?
What sort of doctor?
Well, at this point, I think I'll be a family doctor.
Oh. You mean a doctor with a family or a doctor who looks after family?
That too. I don't know if I can make it. I was up all last night on call.
Were you really?
Yeah.
I've taken call. This murder keeps you up all night. Come on, let's play the feud. I wish you both luck. Remember, $10,000 at stake. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer, and here's the question. Name something you can tell is old just by looking at it. Yeah.
Your teeth.
Your old teeth. Not there. What?
How about your car?
An old car? Very good. You control it. What are you going to do?
Richard, we're going to play.
Okay. They're going to play. You explain your answer, Wynn, and I'll go here and... I've always been fond of saunas, but Shauna is right. Absolutely delightful, you're perfect. Of course, you're with Huckleberry Dillinger here, aren't you? Name something you can tell is old just by looking at it.
Your clothes.
Okay, let's take a look and see if any of our 100 people said clothes. They did not.
Okay, good answer.
That's a strike, and if you get 3 strikes, they get a chance to steal. How are you? You're so gorgeous. You married?
Yes, I am.
Right. Is it serious?
Very.
I won't pursue it any further. What do you say?
I say your shoes.
Okay. Yeah, you can tell that, can't you? Yeah. Show us some old shoes, please. I can't believe that. That's your second sight.
Pet. How about a
kiss? Thank you. How about
now?
Yeah.
How about your furniture?
You can tell us old just by looking
at it. Yes?
Good answer.
Good answer.
You have old furniture?
Yes.
Okay. We want to see furniture, and it better be there. Otherwise, it's their third strike. The Curtis get a chance to steal furniture.
All right.
We saved them. How are you, sir?
So fine, yourself?
Well, your lady is so good because you got two strikes on. What do you say?
About people.
People. Okay.
Good answer.
All right. That's a good answer. People's up there. You're all right. If not, it's your third strike. Old people. You got it. $70 there in that bank. Rod?
Richard, I'm going to say house.
House? Well, that sounds like a good one. Sure. If the house is up there, you're all right. If not, Curtis, get ready. Chance to steal. House! $75. Now, that's quite a comeback, because you got into trouble very early. There's only one answer left, but you got two strikes.
Hello.
What do you say? Something that you can tell is old just by looking at it. All right. Gwen, darling, what answer have you got for me?
Okay.
What do you say?
Skin.
Skin? Okay. That would not be under, or would that be under the class? Yeah, I think it's basically, you know, I think it's compulsory, matter of fact. If you are a person, you must have skin. Now, what do you say?
Carpeting.
Carpeting. All right, fine. If carpeting's there, you get the $75. If not, we're going to give it to the Badger fan. Carpeting! You got it. That's a good answer because carpeting, we'll take a look and see. Number three, please. Food. Well, that's true. If you go to the commissary here, you can always tell that. Little green things all the way over. You got $75. You have nothing. Come on, Angel. Good luck to the lady. Gave you a kiss. Hadn't given you your kiss yet. All right. 100 people serving. Top 5 answers are on the board. Here's the question. If a toy company manufactured a Pat Boone doll, what might it do? Yeah.
Drink milk.
Drink milk. Good girl. 35 people said it. Number one answer still waiting to be revealed.
I have to say sing.
Sing.
Yeah.
Sing!
Good.
You got it?
Pass it.
What are you going to do?
We're going to pass it.
They're going to pass it to you. All right, John. I'll be interested because those are the two things you've learned. Hello.
Hello.
The toy company manufactured a Pat Boone doll. What might it do?
Eat hot dogs.
I don't know if that's a national ad, but for our friends across the country, here in California, a lot of that, eating the hot dogs. About as exciting as drinking the milk. Or listening to him sing, hot dogs! Not bad. So the reason I mention that, because the poll is taken all over the country, you know, and so they might not know about it. One strike. What do you think?
Have daughters.
Ah, that's exactly what he does. And some of the prettiest little ladies in the world. Have daughters! Now, I can't believe that because he's never been able to have a son. It's true, yeah. What did you say?
Smile.
Aha, you're right. All right, Pat Boone smiles up there. You're okay. If not, it's your third strike. Come on now, Pat, smile! $83. Dr. Ron, what do you think?
I think it would wear white shoes.
Oh, that's right.
That's good. They go buckskin or something? Buckskin shoes?
Yes.
They're black, you know. He just spills a lot of milk on them. Want to see white shoes? There's $90 there. This is exactly how that other question ended up, isn't it? Two strikes, but only one answer left. Take a big lead now if you give me the right answer. The toy company manufactured a Pat Boone doll. What might it do?
The only thing I can think of is dance.
Dance.
What, Sean?
Is that good?
Sure. Yes, why not?
Why?
Oh, I think he danced.
You do, really?
Yes, absolutely.
Well, we know he has a lot of daughters. That wasn't there. I've never seen him dance, but maybe if dance is there.
God.
You've got it all in the big lead. If not, get ready, because you'll get a chance to steal. Does Pat Boone dance? Well, here's your chance now. What do you say, Wim?
Okay. Go to church.
That's right. No, he's a very concerned young man, and he has an organization that he works with a lot of young people that get into trouble. I kid around with him, but he really does. So if he's up there, You'll be happy, won't you?
Oh, yeah.
Otherwise, you'll go to his house. Go to church up there, you get the $90. But if not, you take a great big lead in this game. Church! You got it. April love. We'll be back right after this. Countdown. People back. They're trying to get to this game. Just keep them back. No. Keep them back. I'm sorry to take that tone on an evening show, but we've only got a few of these. Hey, with the Family Feud, you know, the home game version, and although we only have a few, we insist that you take one each. And if we have any trouble from you, you'll be forced to take two of each. Now, $90 there, $75 there, let's do it. Come on. Now, I already gave you. You can get a kiss from me.
Yeah.
Thank you. I want to just remind you, 300 points. We'll decide which family plays for the $10,000. I wish you both luck. And here we go. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. Here's the question. The adage says you can't take it with you, but if you could, what would you take? Yeah.
Money.
You would. It'd melt. Money! The number one answer.
We're going to play.
Very good. Hello. How are you?
Very well. Thank you.
You certainly are. Now, it says you can't take it with you, but if you could, what would you take?
Good health.
You would. Of course, if it was that good, you wouldn't go, would you?
Right.
Good health. Not there. First strike. Hello, Lindy.
Hi.
Now, oh, we didn't get it. My nose has got something. What do you say?
Your family.
You would take them. Yeah. No, sometimes like this, I wish I were an orphan there, you know. Ah, Al specific. Yeah, he didn't want to take them all at once. Give me...
Your husband.
Ah. Yeah. Let's call good news and bad news. Good news is we'll never be apart. The bad news is it's adios. Husband! Spouse, good girl. Gwen, what do you think this might be?
Well, your pet dog.
I don't think he'll go as easy as the husband might. All right. Pet dog. No. Oh, my goodness. That's two strikes at best. What do you think now? They say you can't take it with you, but if you could, what would you take?
Well, I'd have to take something to wear, some clothing.
Oh, you would?
Yes.
That's right.
Sure. That sounds good.
Take something to wear, some clothing, and if that's there, you're all right. If not, it's your third strike, and Badger, you can get a chance to steal clothing. Not there. Rod, what did your family come up with?
Children.
What do you think?
Children.
What do you think?
Children. I've got a cute little boy, and I'd sure like to take him with me.
You would.
Right. Children.
Quite a cruel streak, actually. And the doctor there? You know what it means, don't you? Can't take it with you. It means el departe in the world.
El female.
Yeah. You're going to take the kid with you, huh?
Right.
You're a weird doctor.
Could use a vacation.
Okay. And let's take a look. And if that's up there, kids, you get 73 in a big lead. If not, you get the big lead. Kids! You got it? Number 3, please. TV. Let's call Hell on Earth and vice versa. TV. Number 4. Boyfriend or girlfriend. Number 5. Food. Well, of course. You're in the lead with $163. You've got $75. Let's do it. Come on, pretty lady. Dollar values are doubled. 300 now is the game. 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something a dog might chase.
No. A cat.
A cat. Number 1. What are you going to do? Play or pass?
Play.
We're
going
to play.
All right. Lindy, something a dog might chase.
A mailman.
A mailman.
All right.
May we see if any of our 100 people said mailman? They didn't. First strike. My love?
A car.
A car. Great answer, Wynn. Show us car, please. You got it. 156 there. Two answers left. Something a dog might chase.
I think a dog would probably chase another dog.
Good. Good.
Yeah. Okay.
For reasons unspecified. Dog chases dog. Not there. Second strike, Kathy.
Let's see.
Something a dog might chase.
Children running.
Good, good.
Running That's children.
Good. That's
running
a good
children.
One.
All right. Not running water, running children. Running children's up there, you're all right, but if not, you get a chance to get all that money. Children? Not there. What do you say, sir?
False. Stick.
False stick. Newspaper.
Give me an answer, just one. Stick. Might chase a stick. If it's there, you get the $156. If not, you are the champ. You'll play for $10,000. Stick! I don't know, but a ball. And what about his tail? You know, dog? Number three, please.
Oh.
And a ball was one of the answers, right? And the other one I thought was probably his tail. But let's see, number four. Yeah. But dogs do that all the time. They run around here. Well, I wish we had more money so that you could continue your... Well, I'm sure you'll continue it anyway.
Won't quit now.
That's right. You'll just overcharge a couple of us when you become a doctor. I thank you. We've got nice gifts for all of you. And I really thank you for being here. You're a delightful family. Thank you.
Thank you.
Be happy with this class.
Thank you.
And thank you for being here.
Thank you.
You're so lucky. Need two people. Who'll do it? Let's go. Who'll go first? You will?
Yes.
All right. Kathy? Let's see if Wynn wins right after this.
Do you love your cat?
Your granddaughter, Kathy, offstage. She has earphones on. We're going to play for a lot of money. $10,000. Mm-hmm. That's for luck, okay?
Thank you.
15 seconds, please. Name something little girls wear when they play grown-up.
Their mother's shoes.
The most commonly served vegetable.
Carrots.
A famous news magazine.
Newsweek.
A gift most babies receive.
Booties.
A swimming stroke.
Breast.
Thank you, Jim. Here we go. I'm going to take up swimming right away. Now, something little girls wear when they play grown-up, and you said? Mommy shoes, our survey said. 35. The most commonly served vegetable. And you said, what's up, Doc? You said carrot.
You always get them.
And our survey said, three.
Oh, no.
My goodness. Famous news magazine. You said, Newsweek. Our survey said, 46. You got 84. Gift that most babies receive. You said, booties. Our survey said, six. You got 90. And a swimming stroke. And you uttered the famous words, breaststroke. And our survey said,
oh!
Look at that. Turn the ball, please. Come on, real Kathy. Come on, make her feel it. I'm going to ask the same questions that I asked when. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear that. I say try again. You give me another answer. All right, now?
Okay.
You're only 70 points away. Now, please remind everyone the answers Wynn gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock. Name something little girls wear when they play grown-up.
Mother's shoes.
Try again.
A skirt.
A most commonly served vegetable.
Corn.
A famous news magazine.
Newsweek.
Try again.
Time.
A gift most babies receive.
Blankets.
A swimming stroke.
A backstroke.
Turn around. 70 points away. Saw something.
I mean, gosh.
Gosh, yep. Something little girls wear when they play grown-up. You said. Skirt, our survey said. Seven. High heels and lipstick. Number one answer, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Well, you're still in good shape here. I'd say, certainly, yeah. Most commonly served vegetable. You said. Corn for everyone, our survey said.
All
30.
Right.
Oh,
that's
potatoes, number one answer.
Oh, I didn't. Okay.
Didn't occur. No, because that's a new thing they brought out. Now. You are now 33 points away from $10,000. I said a famous news magazine. And you said... farm.
So much news in that one.
Yeah, a lot of news. Like okay. You'll be able to buy lots and lots of, you know, magazines if it's up there. What do you need? 33?
Please let it be.
Just a second. I think there's water under the stage. Our survey for the money said... $1,319 and our love. You have my love. Be here on the field.
Some departing contestants receive from Cody Smitty Does It an exhilarating, exciting collection of Smitty, the spirited, sexy fragrance by Cody, and the serving tray in Lipton Light Lunch, a hot new idea from Lipton, the Jamaican Amok, hearty, delicious, satisfying light lunch, and Rain Dance Car Wax. Lasts longer than any leading car wax, water-beating proves it, furnished by DuPont, and La Machine by Mullinex. The incredible food preparation system from France, it's like having a professional chef right at your side. And next party mix with the best Canada Dry Mixers. Enjoy long-lasting carbonation, smooth taste. Canada Dry Mixers, famous for quality. And the Lather Machine and Dentine Chewing Gum. While you're chewing, it freshens your breath as effectively as mouthwash. Brush your breath with Dentine.
Hey, what the blank is going on here? What the blank is he doing? What kind of a blanking show is this, anyways? I don't believe this blank. Hey, I know her and him. They're blanking hilarious. Oh, get a load of this blank. Holy blank, this is funny. What a great blanking idea for a game show. Match game you'll lap your blank on. Next, only on Game Show Network.